Mr. Speaker, going to war is a big deal. That's why our forefathers put in the Constitution that when America is to go to war, it is Congress that is to lead that charge. It is Congress to authorize America going to war. And that's been the law in the Constitution since it was written. Then came the War Powers Resolution. And Congress decided that it would give a little of that constitutional authority to the president for a period of days until he justified his action before Congress. We can argue whether the War Powers Resolution is constitutional or not, but in any event, Congress has not led America to war in Libya. The president has. The president made that decision. And as James Madison, the author of the Constitution, said in a letter to Thomas Jefferson, and I paraphrase, it has been the history of peoples that it has been the executive branch that has led a country to war. And that's why our Constitution prevented kings and dictators and even presidents from leading this country to war. It must be authorized by Congress. But now we find ourselves in America's at least third war in Libya. The president took us to war, and now on this day we are being asked to support and justify that war in this resolution. I vote no on this resolution. We have no business in Libya. Even the administration has said it's not in the national security interest of the United States to be in Libya. So why are we there? We're there because we don't like Omar Gaddafi. Well, there are a lot of bad guys in the world, and if we start picking them off one at a time, we will be at war with most of the world, because most of the world is led by rogue dictators or bad guys. We have no business being in Libya. We have no business justifying this war on the House floor. It is Congress's responsibility to defund any further action in Libya, and that is what we should do. It's unfortunate we don't have that up or down vote. I wish we could vote up or down today on that issue and let the House decide if we should be in war in Libya. $700 million have already been spent in the war in Libya. It's hard to figure out where that money came from. I get different answers from different people about where the president got that money. But maybe we should spend that $700 million in the United States building America rather than blowing up Libya. I think that would be a better use of funds. We need to take care of America. We shouldn't be involved in somebody else's civil war in Libya. And who are the rebels? We're not sure who they are either. They may be extremists, they may be patriots, they may be a democratic philosophy. We have no idea. I'd ask for another minute.
The gentleman's time has expired.
The gentleman has an additional 30 seconds.
The gentleman's recognized for an additional 30 seconds.
So we don't know who the rebels are. They may be worse than Omar Gaddafi. Now, isn't that a lovely situation? If they take control, we replace an oppressive regime with an extremist radical regime. And that's all because we are in a war that was unauthorized by this Congress, cut off all funds, vote against this resolution, and that's just the way it is. I yield back.